The cloud. All right, there we go. So welcome. Tonight, we are going to talk about how to start sharing oils with your warm market. So first of all, if you're wondering what's a warm market, what's a cold market, I'm sure that you guys have all heard of the term cold calling. That's where you literally pick up your phone. And back when we used to have phone books, you dial through the phone book. That's cold calling. You're calling people that you don't know at all. And if that is what network marketing was, I would run as far as I could the other way, because that's not what I like to do. I'd rather have it be with people. Oh, hi, Betty.
He's not sleeping.
I love it. My dog ran in here. My kids are running outside my door.
Mom life.
It totally is. But warm market is connecting with those people who are people that you know. It's not people that it's your cold market, cold calling. It's like those people that you know. And a lot of people are oftentimes really afraid to reach out to their friends or their family because they're worried, what are they going to think of me? Like, I've flown the coop. I'm using oils now and now I'm selling them. And I had those same feelings when I first started doing this 11 years ago. It can be intimidating to share with those that you know, and you don't want to ever abuse any relationships and have, you know, I know that people don't want to feel like they're taking advantage of their friends and family. So my biggest piece of advice with doTERRA is love the product yourself, because once you love that product, it's hard to keep your mouth shut because you'll see people having different struggles and whatnot. And it's like all you can do to, it's like you're so excited to tell them about a solution you found because you want to help your friends and family. And truthfully, you know, we do a lot of free network marketing. My kids are howling outside of the door. It's fine. Whatever. Anyway, whatever. You know, we do a lot of free marketing for so many companies. Like, for example, my real estate agent, I have referred to him 3 different clients that have closed transactions with him, whether they've bought and sold, whatever. I don't get any commission off that, but I love my real estate agent. I've done a lot with real estate and I've lived in a few different places in the US, and I'm always grateful when I'm doing something with real estate in Utah because I love Aaron. He's so great at it. So I'm always telling people him about it because I'm not getting paid, right? Or a restaurant that you love. You constantly tell people, oh my gosh, you've got to try this restaurant. It's like, I love, there's a ski resort here called Sundance, and there's a really great restaurant called the Tree Room. And I love to tell people about Sundance and the Tree Room, because it's so good. Or the girl that cuts my hair, hey, you should, you know, have she cuts hair, she's so good. So we're constantly doing free marketing for people, and our friends and our family oftentimes listen to us because they know, like, and trust us. They value our opinion because they know, like, and trust us. So if you find something that you love, you know, people may have been introduced to oils before, but once they hear that you like it, they may think, oh, I know Haley, I know Allie, I know Grace, I know Jen, I know that these oils can work so great. Or, I mean, if they like it, then they must be good. And, you know, for me, I could have never gotten involved in a network marketing company that sold something that I don't believe in. Because that would be so, that is when you are constant. Grace, didn't you say, were you doing 31 bags?
Yes. So only because my sister did it, and she, like, she's very pushy. So she kind of wore me down to the point where I just said yes to get her to shut up. But like, I did like nothing with it, to be honest. I got like the enrollment kit, and then I think I just like sold all of my pieces on Marketplace because I wasn't invested. I didn't care.
You didn't believe in it. Right.
Yeah.
Right. And so it was hard for you to sell to the people that your friends and family, because you're like, well, I have a 31 bag or whatever you call it.
And it's like, you can only have so many bags type of thing.
Right. 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 Totally. So yes, it's important that you love the products. That makes it so much easier to get other people involved using whatever you have, because, you know, you love the product so much. So one thing I like to do when I first got started with the business, and I still like to do it, from time to time is just go through and write a list of the people that I know that I think would love oils. Or I'm always listening to my friends and family, like, oh my gosh, my son was up with asthma last night, or we've had the stomach flu, or I've had this headache I can't get rid of. Or we went to Costa Rica with some friends and the sand fleas were so bad this year. I'm going to have like scars from those bug bites because I didn't bring anyway. But I had an oil called Purify that really works. And of course I had to share it with the girl that was with us. And then her kids, one of them threw up in the car and of course shared Digestin with her. But I just write down people who I think would be interested in the oils. And I'm always listening for opportunities. Like, so when I'm driving in Costa Rica and her son threw up all over the floor of the car that we were in, you know, for me, I always grab my oil pouch, sit it on my lap. And I, even 11 years in, it's still normal to feel nervous because I didn't know this girl very well. And I'm like, is she gonna think that I'm annoyed that her, I mean, you know, especially as women, we can overthink. Is she gonna think that I'm annoyed that her kid threw up on the floor? Should I do this? Should I not? You know, holding this pouch of oils. And then finally I'm like, eh, screw it. I'm gonna ask her, which is always what happens. I always, you know, bring it up and like to mention that I have oils. And I just said, you know what? I don't know if you've tried essential oils before, but this one right here is really good if you're car sick. And how you use it is just literally put it right behind your ears and then on your earlobes, because your earlobes are a reflex point for motion sickness. You can also breathe it in and put a little bit on your tummy if you want. And by the end of the trip, she was asking me, I need to buy some of that stuff. That has worked so well. So have oils with you and be listening. That's one way to break into your warm market. Is have them with you and have them there to share. And for me, I truly have an attitude of, if she wants to buy these, great. If she doesn't, it's okay. I wanted to help her son. I didn't want him to feel car sick the whole time because we were doing a lot of driving around. I was also worried about the sanity of our driver because he's a friend of mine and he likes his car very clean. And I could see him like, ah, as soon as her little boy threw up.
Note to self, never get sick in an Uber because it will cost you a minimum of $200.
Really?
Yep.
Oh.
My husband made me find out that piece of information.
Oh. Well, that's good to know. Good to know. Yeah. So that is just one example. You know, I have, and you know, if you're feeling nervous, like, oh my gosh, I don't know enough about my oils. Anybody that I've signed up, which I've signed up all three of you, I gave you a Modern Essentials book. Well, there's also, and you may not have received it yet, Gracie, I know you have yours, but that Modern Essentials book has things in it. And if you're ever wondering, like, okay, I can't always carry that Modern Essentials book with me, you can download the app and it's like $7 and it's a one-time fee. And then you can have that on your phone as a reference. And you can look up things by ailments. So like if someone's like, I have a headache, you could just look it up, like it'll recommend things for headaches and you could see peppermint, frankincense, whatnot. So I always am just listening. So that's the first thing that I do to break into my warm market is I always have my oils with me and I'm listening to people around me and I share my oils. I just will say, hey, do you want to try this? And I keep it simple. I don't, and no pun intended, but I don't like to vomit all over them about the oils. I just say, here, why don't you try this? Here's exactly how you use it. You know, and when it works for them, which it does 99% of the time, they're going to be like, where'd you get that? How do I get more? So that's one way. The other way is I will make a list of everybody that I would like to share the oils with. And then I love to share samples. So when I share samples, I'm really big. First of all, you can get them through doTERRA. They're just little quarter dram sample vials. You can get them on Amazon. Sometimes it's hit or miss on Amazon. Sometimes you'll get samples that may not work as well or bottles. So that's why I do like doTERRA's. And I like to give out samples that are inexpensive. So for example, wild orange is very inexpensive. I also like to give out things that smell good or work really quickly. So Digestin may not be somebody's like favorite drawn to the smell, but if you know their kid is always throwing up or has car sickness, that one might help. But if you're just giving somebody something to smell the oils and think, oh, these are so good. I love any citrus oils. I love peppermint. Citrus Bliss is a blend. It's really good. And I like to just create some samples. And then I like to just you know, strike up a conversation with somebody, I like to hear how they're doing before I'll bring up the oils. So now if it's a really good friend or it's like my mom or something, I have no problem calling my mom and saying, hey, in fact, you know what? My reality is I take an anti-anxiety medicine. I love my oils, but I need an anti-anxiety medicine. Grace is like, hi, I'm Grace. I'm also, so Lexapro works fabulous for me. It has changed my life. I love my oils. It doesn't mean they don't work.
It just which one?
Lexapro. You haven't tried that one?
Oh, no. I'm on Alprazolam. Yeah.
I think that's what I'm on. I think it's the generic for Lexapro.
Okay.
But anyway, works very well. So the other day I called my mom and my mom has anxieties and I'm like, mom, I really want you to take this Lexapro. And I make nothing selling Lexapro, but I'm like, you've seen how much calmer I am. So you can do that same thing with the oils with somebody that you know well, that you have that relationship with, that you can say, okay, mom, like my mom's got arthritis in her knees. And I called her the other day and I was like, you have got to try turmeric soft gels. So you could even write down a list of your people that you're like super comfortable talking to. You could put like a star next to them, like my mom, my sister, my neighbor, my best friend, Sarah, whatever, like people that you don't worry about calling, that you, somebody that you would call and be like, oh my gosh, we just went to this restaurant and it was so good. Those kind of friends that you're already talking to, maybe put a star next to their name, write down why that, like, what is it that came to mind? Is it asthma? Is it it's allergies? Is it anxieties? Is it, trouble sleeping? Is it stomach issues? Is it sore muscles? But just write it down and then get like, call them. Or when you see them, just say, hey, just like you would with your favorite restaurant or your favorite hairstylist or your real estate agent or whoever does pedicures for you. And just say, oh my gosh, you've got to try this. This is working so well for me. And I totally thought of you. Can I give you a sample of this? Like, you know, because when you come from a place of genuinely wanting to help, people can feel that when they're like, oh my gosh, I love this, and let them try it. Just give them a sample of it, but most importantly, show them how to use that oil so that they're not feeling confused. Like, what am I supposed to do with this? You know? Now if it's somebody that I don't know as well, I'm not just going to say, hey, do you want to buy this oil? I'm going to just reach out, and I love to just strike up a conversation with people. How's it going? How are the kids? What's new? And then you can even just, again, you can just say, hey, I have a question for you. Have you ever heard of essential oils? And then just say, and then they may listen to what they say. And then just say, hey, I've been thinking about you. And again, like, these are people that you may not feel as comfortable with, but tell them why you thought of them. Like, I thought about you because I know that you've got headaches all the time, or you've got asthma, and I wanted to give you this little sample of Breathe. Again, the more that I don't, I'm not as close to somebody, I might have a little bit longer of a conversation just to get reacquainted and whatever. And if it's someone that you want to talk to, but I like to call this, but they're on your chicken list, but you're nervous because you're like, I just don't know them that well, or I don't know. Like, I think they'd like it, but I'm super nervous. That is when I ask them what I want them to ask me. So here's what I mean by that. I love to just ask them how it's going, what they're doing, how their kids are. And again, these are people you don't maybe know super well. They're still your warm market, but you may not know them super well. And I love to ask them if they're still working. Are you still working? Are you still cutting hair? You know, what are you doing these days? And usually they'll ask you the same thing in return. And then that is when I'll say, I actually sell essential oils now. Have you tried them? So that can be kind of a way just to comfortably bring it up. Is ask them. And if you're feeling so nervous, like there's no way I could just bring this up, ask them, you know, what are you doing for work these days? How is it going? Because usually they'll ask you the same thing. And then that is a really natural way to say, oh, I actually sell essential oils. And I'm always a big fan of being natural and genuine in your conversations. Like, I don't want you to be fake. I don't want you to, you know, I want you just to get to know people again. And again, the reason I can sell these oils is I love them so much and I love what they do for my family. So those are just some of my tips for sharing oils with a warm market. My family is not paying attention to the fact that someone's at the door. They're super helpful.
What are you guys coming over right now?
I think it's my daughter's friend, her mom. Yeah. So anyway, Grace, do you mind sharing some of the ways that you've reached out to your warm market? Because you've done really well breaking out and sharing oils with people?
Yeah. So, I mean, it's been almost a year. I think my year is like, and like this week coming up on the 22nd. And so I literally started by just creating a Facebook group, and like inviting my, you know, personal contacts to it. And just making it like a community, and me coming from a place of like caring and being genuine and education, because I'm, you know, I'm a teacher by trait. So that's natural for me to want to educate and just let people know that this is out there. And I really took the sales part of it out and just promoted it as like, hey, these are essential oils. If you haven't heard about them, here's what they can do for you and your family. And just made it more of like an educational standpoint and not from like me trying to sell it standpoint, if that makes sense.
Yeah. Yeah. I love it. I love it. And Allie and Haley, you're welcome to chime in, ask questions, whatever. Cause I love discussions too. Like if you have questions, if you have comments, if you're wondering, well, whatever questions you have, I'm happy to answer them. Cause that's definitely what I love to do, is just chat, see how it's going. And of course, complain about my kids outside the door when I don't want them to be. And then long gone when I, anyway. Yeah.
I think something that I would have a question about is just like today I had a girl, I live in a very small town. So I had a girl say, who sells essential oils? And I was like, me. And she messaged me. And she just flat out asked, do you have any info? And I'm like, well, what is she wanting info on? The oils? Yeah. The prices? Like, I was so confused. I'm like, I didn't know how to answer her, you know?
Yeah. So usually what I do in situations like that is I will say exactly what you did. What is it that you're wanting to know? Or how can I help you? I'd love to help you. Yeah. And I like to, is it somebody that you know?
Yeah, I mean, I know her. We come from like a really small town. Like I graduated with 60
people. I know everybody in my town, yeah.
Yes, and so I know her and like, I feel comfortable talking to her, but I was just like I wanted to like be professional about it, you know? Mm-hmm. And so I was like, ooh. And so I just asked her like, kind of like, what are you exactly looking for? And I told her that it's not just essential oils that doTERRA sells. And so mm-hmm. she was like, okay. And I told her that I had a meeting with y'all tonight and mm-hmm. that I would have more information tomorrow and stuff.
And yeah. Like, oh, and that is so perfect. I love that so much. If you're ever unsure of what to say, there is never any problem with saying, you know what, let me find out and get back to you. Like, I love that. That's so perfect.
Yeah.
Cause I mean, if you think about it, does it ever bug you when people say that to you? If they say, no, let me find out. Yeah.
Yeah.
So don't ever feel like you have to have the answers. So what I like to do with situations like that is sometimes I love to just run over a sample of like peppermint or orange or just something really simple and just say, hey, I know you had asked about these. I wanted to just let you try some and then tell her like a very simple way to use the oil. So for example, if you dropped off peppermint, you could just say, this is good for like, if you have a headache, this is good for sore muscles. And it's a good oil to just put on topically. So whatever hurts, use it topically, just keep it away from your eyes because it can sting your eyes. So I'll do something really simple like that. Because usually that will open up a conversation and just mm-hmm. say, you know, and you can even just set up a time to meet with her. And have you received your book from me yet?
Mm-mm.
Probably
I've only received my kit that I had ordered.
You got it so fast. That's awesome.
I did.
I'm so happy that shipping is getting back to normal. Cause with COVID for a while, I was like, good grief. When are they getting the kit? But I like to just get them just let them try it and then just say, what is it that you want to know? And I like to spend most of my time asking them what they want. What are you wanting to know? And then you can either, like, you could download that app for $6. Grace, mm-hmm. do you remember how much that app cost? Is Grace still on?
What'd you say?
Do you remember how? Me. No, you're fine. Do you remember how much the Modern Essentials app is?
Like $15, I think.
Oh, is it 15 now?
But it's for the year. Like it's a yearly
subscription.
Yeah.
Anyway, you could download an app so that you feel like you have a resource right now. But I love to just write down like, what are your health concerns or goals that is making it so you're interested in oils, and just literally just write them down. And then, and next week I'll do a little bit more on how to do like a presentation with somebody. In fact, I will send you a training, a recording of how to do a one-on-one with somebody. But what I like to do is just answer their questions and just spend my time listening,
right,
listening to them, and then just showing how the oils can help.
Seriously, I've used like Young Living and stuff, and these were crazy. Like, I used them and I slept amazing. And I'm a daycare. I work at a daycare, so I work in the pre-K. I have had those on every day, all day long up there since I got them.
Grace, you used to work in pre-K, didn't you?
Yeah, my degree is in education, so I'm licensed to teach up to third grade. But yeah, I've done every age group up to first grade. And then I was an admin for a long time.
That's working awesome on my EC through six right now.
Okay.
Yeah. Is this the, I don't know if y'all can see it. Maybe it'll, is this the app?
Uh-huh.
Okay. It's just $3.99. That's what it says.
Oh, what am I thinking of? Oh, you know what? Okay. I'm thinking of, it's called My EO. But I really liked it because it breaks down like the body, the oil, and you can do like mental health, just a list of the oils and what they do, and then physical health. So you can scroll through and be like, okay, acne or eczema or heartburn, or, and you can pick your physical symptom and it'll bring up a list for you. It's called My EO. And okay. I think that one's $15. Yeah.
Yeah. I love, that's why I love getting together and chatting, because people know stuff that I don't and they have really great ideas. So I love to hear other great ideas, because I always learn new stuff that way. So yeah, it's nice to have a nice little reference right on your phone. So when someone says, what do you do for eczema? And you're like, well, I don't know. You
could look at your... a friend of mine texted me the other day asking about eczema, I think it was. And I'm like, whoop, here you go.
Like, actually, I can help you with that. That's perfect. Allie, do you have any questions or comments? Or
yes, I do. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Sorry, I'm not showing my face, but I look like death warmed over. So
I'm not gonna show. Don't worry about it. I'm getting over COVID, so last week I had my video off too.
I'm not showing myself.
I have never used oils, and so one of my thing is. When somebody says, what is the difference between the other oils and your oils and all that? And I have tried to really study doTERRA, but it's like, I don't know, there's so many people selling the other oils, and it's like, so what, how do you handle that?
So for me, I don't ever let you in my head. I think negative things about other oil companies, if I'm being super honest. I'm like, well, they adulterate their oils or whatever. I don't ever like to vocalize that to them. I just like to talk about the positives of doTERRA. And I, you know, the big things with doTERRA that I like is, first of all, their sourcing. So we don't really care to own our own farms. doTERRA does own a couple of the farms, but they want to work with the resident expert of lavender or lemon or tea tree or geranium or frankincense. Like, they want to work with that family that's been farming that plant or tree or whatever that the oil comes from for decades, and they know their things. So doTERRA is very picky about who they partner with, and they actually have farmers reach out to them all the time, because doTERRA is the largest oil company in the world, and if you land a contract with doTERRA, that's incredible. But doTERRA is very picky about who they'll source their oils from. Okay. And then they test, they have a third party company that tests every single batch. So we want to make sure there's no fillers, weeds, you know, pesticides, chemicals, things like that. And the nice thing is they actually, hi buddy, what oil do you have?
He's playing with them. Which one do you have, baby? What does it smell like? He is purifying.
But there's actually a number on the bottom of each oil that you can put in a website that doTERRA has called Source to You, and you can pull up the test. So I'm giving you more than you need to give them. You don't want to fire hose them. I'm just trying to give you some more background info. But I just basically, they say the sourcing, they like to source their oils from where they grow the best. they test all their oils, and you can actually look at the test results online. So really it's a quality thing. So 90, and this is again more background info. You don't need to feel like you need to share this with everybody, but 95% of essential oil companies have adulterated their oils in some way or another. Most of them don't know because they've purchased through a broker. So really it really is a quality thing. And I usually like to just let people smell it. Cause like, Haley's tried other oils and she was like, oh my gosh, these are just crazy. These work so well. People have that same experience. So I like to just say, hey, you know what? Why don't you smell it? Or why don't you try it and see how it works for you? Cause and when I say that, I'm letting them smell or try what I have.
Right.
So that was a little, I gave you way more of the information than I would give somebody else unless they wanted to know more, but I just say quality. We're very picky about where we source from. We have exclusive contracts with 96% of our farmers. And then we test every batch of oils so that you can make sure that they're super good quality, and they post them so that you can see. So that's my little, the long and the short of it, if that's how the saying goes.
I was talking to my sister, and like I said, I do not have a clue about the other oils, but I was talking to my sister this afternoon, and I had mentioned that when I first got my box, I dropped one little tiny drop in my water, mm-hmm. and how after I finished my water, I went and got more water, and it still had the lemon taste in the mm-hmm. ice. And she was like, you mean you can eat these oils? You know, you can swallow these oils. They're not poison. And so I'm like, you can't all of them, but you know, they have oregano and things like that. And I said, I'm just learning all this, which is exciting because it's so much you can tell people about. When somebody can use something that they've spent 15 to however much dollars on, and you tell them, yeah, you can use this in your cooking. You can use this in your smoothie. You can use this, that, and another. That makes it even more valuable to people.
Right. Yeah. I love it. Yeah. That's just sharing your testimony of why you like the oil and what you have found with it. You know, people purchase from those who they know, like, and trust. You know, if some random person tells me what to do, I'm like, I don't know them. But with someone who knows me, says try this, I'm like, okay, I will.
A lot of people that know me know that I have suffered from because I love my house to smell good, but I can't use those plugins or anything like that anymore. I'm so allergic to them. And so, you know, I'm like, they know I've been trying this and trying that, and it's like nothing's working for me. And now I found something that works, that's natural, that, you know, and so that is going to be something that even if I don't, you know, become top whatever of the company, which I probably won't, but anyway, can share with somebody that's had headaches when they use plugins. I can help somebody with this, that, and another. And that's important to me because I've suffered and I just never realized what was causing my headaches, my eyes to, you know, water and just all this. And then when I realized what it was, then I just unplugged it and it was gone, you know, it was crazy.
Eat an oil.
I love your testimonial of it. Cause I think it's very powerful. And you know, you could even do like a girls' night as things start to open up more, or as you feel comfortable. One thing I like to do is Valentine's Day. I love to have people come over and make pillow sprays or linen mist and chocolates with the oils. And, you know, that's a good way to introduce people too. Just say, hey, I wanted to do a little fun craft night, or, you know, and let people make something aromatic. So I love it. I love, 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 love it. Haley, do you have any other questions, comments?
I have one more question. So I actually just had, because I commented on that girl's Facebook and I said, I sell essential oils, and someone else just messaged me and she wants my link. So I haven't made any sales or anything.
Okay.
How do I do that?
So you can get a link. So did we upgrade you to Wellness Advocate?
I don't think so.
Okay. So what you're going to want to do is sign it. It's free. You'll want to sign into your office. Have you done that yet? Like where you go to doTERRA.com and use your username and password.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So go to account profile. So you find that on the top right, there's like a little person, a little head and shoulders of a stick person. Okay. And then you'll click on account profile and you'll find where it'll let you upgrade okay. accounts.
Okay. My Wi-Fi is being slow.
That's okay. That's the job of Wi-Fi, I've decided.
Yeah. Okay. You said on account, right?
Uh-huh. So account. Okay. So you're going to click on the little stick person up top, top right. Yes. Allie, where did you find it? You did it today. Is Allie muted? I just saw that her upgrade came through. So if you go to account profile, top right.
Yeah, I don't know if I can walk anybody through it. It's so new. But it's super simple. If I can do it, anybody can do it. You just...